much for coming. You will hear several songs while we perform, but really this is kind of done in one big piece. It's a reader's theater, so it's sort of like a mini musical. And we hope you enjoy our rendition of The Alphabet Tree. And I would also like to thank Miss Phillips. Actually, Miss Turk was going to narrate, and Miss Phillips had to step in for her, and she's amazing. So enjoy her and the students and their singing, and we hope you do like this version. All right, we're going to start with a song called Standing Like a Tree. Boys and girls who are playing instruments and narrating, please come. I wanted to also point out that the artwork that you see, the leaves, were done in their art class with their art teacher, Miss Thomas. And we were able to incorporate them as part of our presentation tonight.
This is the alphabet tree.
Because not so long ago, this tree was full of letters. They lived a happy life, hopping from leaf to leaf on the highest twigs. Each letter had its favorite leaf, where it would sit in the sun and rock in the gentle breeze of spring.
Don't let the wind blow here no more. Oh.
When the storm had passed, they huddled together in fear, deep in the foliage of the lower branches. A funny bug, red with big black dots, saw them there, hiding in the shade.
We are hiding from the wind, but who are you?
I am the word bug. I can teach you to make words. If you get together in threes and fours and even more, no wind will be strong enough to blow you away.
Join together and make words. Some made short and easy words like dog and cat. Others learned to make more difficult ones, twig, leaf, and even earth. Happily, they climbed back onto the highest leaves, and when the wind came, they held on without fear. The word bug had been right. Amid the foliage. He was purple, woolly, and very large. He saw the words scattered around the leaves.
Such confusion, why don't you get together and make sentences and mean something?
The letters had never thought of this. Now they could really write, say things. They said things about the wind, the leaves, the bug.
Good, but not good enough.
Why?
Because you must say something important.
The letters tried to think of something important, really important. Finally, they knew what to say. What could be more important than peace? Peace on earth. Goodwill to all, they spelled excitedly.
This is my
Okay, we are going to perform a story called, it's similar to what the second graders did. It's by the same author too. It's called Tico and the Golden Wings. And this is also going to be a musical theater production of this story. And we're going to start with a song called Yellow Bird.
I love the mountains. was standing behind me.
I am the wishing bird. Make a wish and it will come true.
I remembered my dreams, and with all my might, I wished I had a pair of golden wings. Cautiously, I flapped my wings, and then I flew. I flew higher than the tallest tree. The flower patches below looked like stamps scattered over the countryside, and the river like a silver necklace lying in the meadows. I was so happy, and I flew well into the day. Saw me swoop down from the sky, they frowned on me.
Go away, you want to be different. Go away, you want to be different.
And off they flew without saying another word. Why had they gone? Why were they angry? Was it bad to be different? I could fly as high as the eagle. My wings were the most beautiful wings in the world, but my friends had left me, and I was very lonely.
Invisible golden dreams.
The end.